Welcome to another DK Custom Products video. My name is Kevin, this is Dwayne.
And today we're gonna talk to you guys about one of the most important maintenance checks you can do on your motorcycle, your tire pressure.
And it's a little thing that can make a big difference. This is a little thing that can make a big difference and is something that most of us are guilty of not keeping up with.
Yeah. Yeah, and before we get started, if you guys could like, comment, and subscribe to our channel, it would really help us out.
So why is checking tire pressure so important? Keeping the PSI set correctly on your tire is so important.
Well, your tire pressure is directly related to traction, tire durability, handling, comfort, reliability, and overall safety, not just for you, but for other people on the roadway.
Right. So the first thing to know about setting your PSI to the correct amount is, what is the correct amount? Every tire on the side has max PSI, but that max PSI is related to the max weight for that tire. So let's take trike tires, for instance. Mm-hmm. The tires that come on the back of a trike are for a car. And the max PSI is 44, but it's also for 1,400 pounds per tire. Mm-hmm. Well, what we found is that 20 to 22 PSI is the correct PSI for those tires on the
correct
back of a trike. Mm-hmm. Where you take on this front tire, this Dunlop factory, Dunlop OEM, Dunlop tire on this Softail, the max PSI is 40, but this bike doesn't weigh anywhere near
right
as much. So in the manual, I believe it says that it's 36. So look either on the frame of the bike or in the manual for what the correct PSI is for the tires on your particular bike. Once you know what the correct PSI is, then it's important to check it. Some people check it every ride, some people check once a week, but you definitely don't want to go months without checking your PSI.
Right. Yeah, and we understand some of us don't ride every single day, so it's not abnormal for some bikes to sit for a solid month, 2 or even 3 months at a time. And it's worth noting that you can lose up to one PSI per month with the bike just sitting there.
Or riding it. I mean, they're not 100% airtight. They're going to lose some pressure. And on average, it's a pound per month.
Right. And it's not just time. Also, ambient temperatures play a role. You know, your temperatures increase or decrease by 10. That's going to increase or decrease PSI a solid pound.
Right. So, and which brings up another thing is that always set your PSI when the tires are cold. By cold, I don't mean cold outside, but you haven't ridden it. When you ride it, it heats up the tires. So it's 75 degrees today. If I were to check these tires, I would check them right now. I have not ridden it. Check it right now and set it. Mm-hmm. And it would be the correct PSI at 75 degrees. But 2 months from now when I'm riding and it's maybe 45 degrees, I'm automatically going to have less, 3 PSI less, because it's 30 degrees less ambient temperature. Because every 10 degrees is about 1 pound.
Right.
Okay, but 3 months will have gone by also, right?
Yeah, that's another 3 pounds.
That's another 3, so 6. So if I set them at, right today, 75 degrees, and I set them at 36 PSI, and 3 months from now when it's 45 degrees and I haven't done anything, I'm automatically, my 36 is gonna be 30. And if I'm at 30 PSI on that front tire, I'm not gonna have as good a traction. Mm-hmm. The tire's not gonna wear as well. It's going to be squirmy. It's not going to handle as well. I was riding a bike the other day, a customer's bike, and I'm going, man, what is the matter with this thing? Because every time I went to turn just a little bit left or a little bit right, it wanted to go all the way left or all the way right. It was really squirmy and was really following the tar snakes really bad. And it was because his tire pressure was like 8 pounds below what it should have been. So, Dwayne, I'm going to read you something from Dunlop. Dunlop technicians were surprised to find that 40% of the bikes whose tire pressures they measured at a rally were substantially underinflated. 40%.
I can believe it because I'll admit I'm guilty of it. You know, just you come out there, you crank the bike, and you ride off. And I've went solid weeks without checking tire pressure.
So if by chance we've given you some motivation to check your tire pressure on a regular basis, what's an important component of checking tire pressure? What's a necessary component of checking
tire
pressure?
Well, some people, you know, they do the old kick the tire, and if your foot bounces off, it's got too much. If it doesn't, it's too little. But a tire pressure gauge is key. You know, in a pinch, the basic ones that shoot the little rod out with the readouts, those are fine. They're good, but they're not the best. The best, a good tire gauge, give you an accurate reading, that's fairly important.
Yeah, and you want to have a known. So, like, I probably in this shop have four or five different tire gauges.
Yeah.
And so what I would do is I would use three or four of them. And if three of them are all reading the same, I'm going to go, you know, that's probably the right PSI,
yeah, right.
Probably reading correctly. And the one that's reading differently is wrong. But that's not a for sure thing. So you want to have a known, like I have two different that I carry, have in Mary's truck, two different electronic gauges and two different digital gauges. One of them is consistently 2 pounds under the other.
Yeah.
And I know that. One of them is correct. I've checked it against a bunch of others. And the other one is 2 pounds below. The other thing that I use is, you know, I have my little USB. Let me go grab it. I have my little USB rechargeable air compressor here. It also has a built-in PSI gauge right here on this little screen. The first thing I did when I got this, when I purchased this, is I tested this gauge against a bunch of known good gauges to make sure this was accurate. So I can turn this on and air something up until the PSI that I want it to be at.
Yeah.
This thing is really, really handy. But you got to make sure that your gauge is accurate. Otherwise, you think you're airing up to 36 when you're really only airing up to 32. That doesn't do you much good. I like this thing so much. I've had it a year, year and a half. I told a friend about it. He ordered one. He got it. He's been using it. And then when we were all together on a ride the other day, there was a guy there with like a $200 air gauge.
Yeah.
And he went around and checked everybody's tire pressure. Mine was within 1 pound of what this said it was and what his gauge said it was. This is what my tires were at. But there's other guys who had bought one of these. His was at the right PSI according to his one of these things. But it was like 6 pounds off according to mine and this other guy's really expensive gauge. He didn't check the gauge when he bought this. And so all this time he's been airing up using a faulty gauge.
Yeah.
And always he's had the wrong PSI in his tires all along. So always have a good gauge, double check it against some known gauge. So a tire that is inflated to the correct PSI, it's going to have some give in it, so it's going to give you some comfort. It's going to have some flex in it, going to give you some comfort. It's going to be the largest contact patch on the road, so it's going to give you the best traction, okay? It's not going to be squirmy because it's underinflated or really hard and skip because it's overinflated, so it's going to handle the best. So the important things about... So those are the reasons that you want to keep your tire at, and it's going to last longer.
That's a lot
longer,
yeah.
Going to last longer because as the tire rolls, it generates heat. And when it's at the ideal PSI is when it's generating the least amount of heat, but giving you the best traction, the best ride, the best handling.
Right. And I think it's worth mentioning that if you ride with your tire underinflated too long, you've already compromised the sidewall.
Right.
And, you know, there's other issues that can go unseen about a tire that you don't want to get into.
Right. So bottom line is check your tire pressure regularly. Check it with a gauge that you know is accurate, and do it when the tires are cold, not after you've been right after you've been riding the bike.
I hope this video helped you guys out. Y'all ride safe out there.